Sir, for such insightful thoughts, and I think the stage has been set for the further deliberations. We have with us Mr. Sanjay Bhusa Reddy. He has come. I would request Mansi Mishra ji to please welcome him, and we will take forward the proceedings. Setting out the ideal for technical education that it should unleash the integrity of the individuals, we move forward. Just a historical analysis, like India used to account for 33% of the world GDP. India led the world in GDP before the Industrial Revolution. And following the end of British rule, India entered a long period of economic stagnation. Future outlook comes from Goldman Sachs, which sees India passing US economy in 2015, trailing only China. The last quarter, October, November and December, saw the visit of the top leaders of the world powers, starting with President Obama, to the Prime Minister of China, to the President of France and all. So there has been a massive, and all came for trade tie-ups with India. So somewhere like a major shift in geopolitics is happening. And a question then comes, like, shouldn't India start exploring additional and alternate avenues of economic growth by empowering our own local area development initiatives? What sir mentioned summarily, like engineers, like they should be seen as knowledge professionals spanning across various areas, and they can be put to use to various domains. So just quick snippets, 42% of world's poor live in India. India has 568 million more registered voters than the US. This means a like, lot of population, what sir was mentioning, not much has changed in the rural areas. They depend on the government services, they depend on the development of the developmental ecosystem. India's tech capital, Bangalore, has increased its office supply by 6 times, and the property prices in Mumbai and Delhi have more than doubled in the past 18 months. Can't the requisite ecosystem be generated in our tier 2 and tier 3 cities? Now, with this question in mind, we had been, UPT Watch has been understanding it, unraveling it. We had a day-long symposium at Banda, which happens to be one of the most backward regions of Uttar Pradesh, on the theme of engineering institutions as growth centers for local area development. I now invite Mr. Sanjay Bhusa Reddy, sir, to deliver his talk on ideas for accentuating the ideal of technical education, synergizing local development initiatives with technical education.
Very good afternoon, friends. The weather is a bit dicey, but I think Raghav is keeping the deliberations quite warm and interactive. I welcome all the senior, my senior colleagues on the dais. Mittal sir, who has always been a guide to not only to engineers but also to the IS fraternity. I also welcome the Vice Chancellor, the Director of the Academy, and my very good friend, Mr. Raghav Mittal, young colleagues of this institute, ladies and gentlemen. Raghav met me few months back and with very good and bright ideas, and he said whether the IAS fraternity through its association can we do something to bring in the institutes when the students are actually undergoing their postgraduate, graduate programs, diplomas, postgraduate programs, and what's actually in the field. And it was a wonderful idea which we clicked and we agreed upon, and we decided that let's have an internship partnership of these students, as well as you are already into partnership with various industries. You go for summer placements, you go for winter placements. But generally it is an industry and private sector. With Raghav, his idea was whether we can also bring it to public sector. I said yes, the idea is very good. And it's an idea which should fructify, because ultimately all engineers, or for that matter any graduate, postgraduate, at some point of time has to interact with public offices, organizations. Then they feel that they don't know anything about organization in public domain, because in private sector it's very close and straight-jacketed organizations. Jitne bhi industries hoti hai, organizations hote hai, they are quite straight-jacketed. The processes are quite defined. As against that, in public sector, public domain, the organizations are like maze. You just don't know. If I say government, what is government, where is government, you find it very difficult. It's also correct that when you learn a particular subject or a particular faculty, engineering kariye, medicine kariye, so when you are a student, you learn lots of theories, and suddenly when one day with the package which our sir was saying, 30 lakhs, 40 lakhs, you reach to some industry, and when you are working on job, you realize ki jo professor saab logo ne padhaya tha yahan to kuch samajh mein nahi aa raha hai. Either you are into marketing. Marketing is a totally different ball game. If you are into very pure into floor shop, then perhaps some production side or technical side is applicable. And that happens when you are in public sector also. Therefore, and if you see the other side while learning, which is to some extent was in vogue and it is still in vogue in medicine, you actually go and work in the hospitals when you are in third year and fourth year of medicine. So you know what are you being taught and how it's put to application. In other faculties, it's not so. Since last 10 years or a decade or so, this has started in engineering colleges also, of summer placement and winter placement, especially after the advent of IT. It started. And when they come there, they are totally at a loss. Suppose if you are a very good student of computer programming, and I give you a project in public domain, chances of you succeeding that project or handling it successfully is not more than 5%. If it's an ERP type of a project in a manufacturing sector, perhaps you will finish off that project and maybe successfully with some glitches, bugs here and there, which will get rectified. But in public domain it becomes difficult. Therefore, when Raghav came, he said yes, we would do the hand holding to take all of you, all the students, as an intern. They can do one summer placement or winter placement in the private sector to learn the manufacturing side and ERP solutions there, or whatever engineering solutions. But they should also work either for the winter or summer placement for 3 months or 4 months, or for a project or on a project in public sector also. Because public sector, there are lots of complexities. It's not so simple. It's not so easy. There are various factors. There is nothing in your control. Everything is beyond your control. And with those parameters at hand, you have to deliver and successfully implement the project. We agreed. Unfortunately, Raghav is also very busy. Here I was also out of station because of election observer duty. So we couldn't do it. But I take this opportunity as a formal platform to agree that we would be too keen to do and put all you students as intern in government offices on various projects where you can actually run either a particular project or making an IT solution or getting into the public domain with IT solution, various departments. ऐसे बहुत projects हैं, बहुत सारा है. Fortunately, now there is no dearth of funds, there is no dearth of technology, even in government, there is no dearth of budget, and there is no dearth of hardware and software. पहले हम आपको बुला भी ले, तो हम आपको कहाँ काम कर रहे हैं? हमारे पास 386486 होता था. We were very, there was a wide gap and lag between the industry, the private sector and the government sector. Now we have very high degree of infrastructure, but what we are doing is word processing. Whereas if you see, I only take one segment of computerization or IT solutions, word processing is just 0.1% or 0.5% or at least 1% of the total potential of computer. Or the hardware and software which we have. Even if we take the most simplest one of Microsoft, MS Office and all that, and whatever package, full Microsoft package, उसमें जितना access और तमाम चीजें हैं, उसका भी हम लोग केवल 1% of less than a percent हम utilize कर रहे हैं. So with those infrastructure, but we have much more in terms of hardware and software. So we would invite you. We would love to work with you and you would also get a lot of satisfaction for which we may not be able to pay you anything, but definitely we will give you credits for that and certificates from that particular organization would be given to the student so that it may help you in your future career. With this, because this is what on the topic on which you had asked me to discuss with you. I am grateful to Raghav and this institute for giving this and Kripa Shankar ji, our Vice Chancellor, Honorable Vice Chancellor is here. What I would request, sir, we had thought of making a tripartite with UPTU and the various engineering colleges and the government. We can have a tripartite sort of a thing and we have various projects on which all our young engineers can work and ultimately the public would benefit, the state of Uttar Pradesh would benefit, the nation would benefit, the student would benefit and incidentally the government would also benefit. So it can be a win-win situation for all of us. I look forward to work with all youngsters. Youngsters ke saath kaam karne mein achha lagta hai, thoda sa young feel hota hai. So that's one more reason why I am always in very easily agree to programs in colleges and universities. Otherwise, तो बहुत सारी चीजें pessimistic होती हैं. I was tempting to start my lecture with where Mittal sir had closed, but I thought I would leave it to Mittal sir. He has given you very good ideas. I don't know how many of you have actually been able to churn. उन्होंने खूब सारा मतलब 20-25 किलो बम्बार्ड कर दिया है. अगर आप लोगों ने बहुत ध्यान से सुना होगा तो उन्होंने अपने जीवन का निष्कर्ष निचोड़ के दिया है. उनको आप यहाँ से जाने के बाद आराम से भोजन के बाद ठंड में कंबल में उसके सोचिएगा. तो बहुत गंभीर बातें उन्होंने कही है. एक उदाहरण मैं दूंगा जबकि मेरा टॉपिक नहीं है. व्हाट आई वॉन्टेड टू से यू आई हैड टोल्ड यू सर आई हैव बीन टू मैसूर रिसेंटली फॉर अ ट्रेनिंग ऑन नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज. देयर आई हैड फाउंड as a professor or as a guest lecturer on what do we call it? Non-fertilizer based agriculture. That is, that I use as organic agriculture. Friends, let me tell you, there are a couple in Mysore, 50 kilometers from Mysore. The husband came and delivered us a lecture of how agriculture can be made sustainable, agriculture engineering also into it, without any formal this. They are a couple. The boy इस करियप्पा जो मेजर जनरल करियप्पा उनका रिलेटिव है, नीस और नेफ्यू है. एंड हिज वाइफ इज हिज मदर इज अ पंजाबी फ्रॉम चंडीगढ़. ही मैरिड अ गर्ल हुज मदर इज एन अमेरिकन एंड वाइफ हस्बैंड अ मैसूरियन. तो दोनों बच्चे एक प्रकार के हैं और दोनों दिल्ली स्कूल ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स से 1986 में इकोनॉमिक्स किया है. They did their post graduate. Immediately after the post graduation, they went to Mysore and bought 15 acres of agricultural land. Pahar kharida basically, 4000 acre ke hisab se. And they decided to do agriculture. So a boy, his father is a Karyappa from a very well-to-do family, mother a Punjabi from Chandigarh, and married to a girl whose father is a Mysorean and mother an American. Doing PhD, postgraduate from Delhi School of Economics, going and doing farming. That day I also visited the farm. Now they have around 40 acres. They have two sons. They have not put their sons into formal education. And those boys have learned agriculture, engineering and agriculture on job, on field. And they devise their own instruments and implements. Khud karte hai. और कोई फॉर्मल एजुकेशन नहीं है. हाथ की बोरी आती है, ट्रक से उतारते हैं, सामान लाते हैं. द सक्सेस इज दैट दे डोंट सेल एनीथिंग रॉ. दे ग्रो केन, दे डोंट सेल केन, दे सेल जैगरी प्रोसेस. दे पैकेटेड अगेन इन एन एनवायरमेंटली फ्रेंडली पैकेटिंग विच इज सोल्ड इन एडवांस एंड इट्स ऑल no fertilizers. They buy only kerosene, matchstick, salt and petrol and diesel. That's all. Everything they produce at their farm. Hence all organic. Haar, gobar, janwar, baldin, all that. So what sir was saying, the only package and industry is not the world. World is a very big place. Rather, with big packages, I find in 15-20 years, boys and girls are getting burnt out. बुरी तरह से बिल्कुल बेकार हो जा रहे हैं. किसी का किडनी फेल हो रहा है और सबसे पहले तो उनकी शादी फेल हो रही है. Unfortunate. With lots of money, they don't know how to enjoy. So what's the point of this money? I should not disclose it, but I'm disclosing it. The highest number of divorces are amongst IT. And young graduates from engineers, engineering college with high packages. Husband Dinbar software bana tha, bhai Bradbar software bana ki hardware ban nahi raha hai. So friends, I was tempted to continue with what sir said, but I leave it to sir. My limited was how to synergize local developmental issues. I would request in public sector, there's a lot of work, there's a lot of challenges. It's really difficult to get things moving in public sector. But when young, energetic minds would come to us with a lot of capabilities and competence, I'm quite sure in public sector you will get an opportunity to do something worthwhile. Just be there for 3 months, 1 month, 2 months, and try to do something and contribute something for nation building. जब nation building होगा तो state building हो जाएगा, state building UP बन जाएगा तो राष्ट्र भी बन जाएगा. चाहे उसे आप किस तरह से भी देख ले, but let's work for nation building and let's enter into a partnership. I am not talking of partnership, private sector partnership से डर लगता मुझे. I am talking of public sector partnerships. Let's work for partnerships. Don't expect anything. We will only give you credentials, we'll give you credits. I can't do anything more, I can't give you anything more, but you will get lots of blessings. And सबसे बड़ी बात ये होगा कि जब वो public domain में, public policy में project होगा आपका successful entrepreneurship, आप जो भी वहां दिखाएंगे, आप जो product develop करेंगे, एक company में आप काम करेंगे, 5000 लोग आपके अधीन ज्यादा से ज्यादा काम करेंगे, 500 लोग काम करेंगे और उसका reflection ज्यादा से ज्यादा लाख लोगों के बीच में होगा. पब्लिक सेक्टर में जब आप काम करोगे तो उसका असर 16 लाख करोड़ तक देश की आबादी पे होगा, जो अब नेक्स्ट सेंसस जो चल रहा है उसमें हम लोग समवेयर अराउंड 20.5 करोड़ होंगे। 20 करोड़ पे आपका रिफ्लेक्शन होगा और संतुष्टि और आशीर्वाद भी आपको 20 करोड़ का मिलेगा, या 100 करोड़ के भारत की आबादी से आपको मिलेगा और आपका रिफ्लेक्शन उस स्तर पे होगा। व्हाट निलंकानी कुन डू देयर, परहैप्स ही मे बी एबल टू डू हियर एंड गेट दैट रिकग्निशन। सिमिलरली यू कैन ऑल्सो गेट दैट रिकग्निशन इफ यू वर्क इन पब्लिक सेक्टर, क्योंकि यहाँ तो पूरा दुनिया आपको देखेगा, पूरा राष्ट्र और पूरा प्रदेश आपको देखेगा। मुझे पूरा विश्वास है कि आप लोग कुछ समय कुछ अपने जीवन के क्षण कुछ निकालेंगे और पब्लिक सेक्टर में भी काम करने का प्रयास करेंगे और देश को और प्रदेश को से लाभान्वित करेंगे। मैं अपनी वाणी को यहीं विराम दूंगा, लेकिन आपसे मंथन चिंतन वार्ता